The Inforiver Standard Edition delivers the fastest way to build visualizations and paginated reports in Power BI, including the creation of IBCS-compliant P&L and financial statements, variance reports, and visualizations in a single click. It's also one of the few pieces of software to be certified by IBCS for the International Business Communications Standards. The Standard Edition also comes with a wide range of in-cell table and matrix visualizations with interactive menu-based navigation and one-click formatting options for unparalleled in-user self-service, interactivity, and collaboration experiences. The IBCS templates can be easily accessed by coming up to the Home ribbon, selecting Templates, and you have one of five templates to choose from. The Variance bars are good for simple comparisons. Variance waterfalls are good for showing distribution. The Measure rows are good for providing a clean layout of the numbers. This last one, called Numeric, is very powerful as well. If we zoom out a little bit, we can see that it shows us the very latest month in the date periods that we have over on the left. And on the right is the cumulative total between the start and end of the date periods, with an option to actually select further down into the list via a dropdown. If I close this template menu here, you can see that there's a list of the available fields that I can also filter further as well. Row and column reordering can be easily achieved using the drag and drop method. If I wanted to move computers up to the top, I select it, drag it up to the top, and release. Same thing with any of the subcategories or any of the columns. Notes can be added also at the column, row, or cell level. To add a note, we come up to the notes on the home ribbon, select add new note, type in a comment here, and select save. With the standard edition, the comments will be saved directly inside of the model, and you'll get a symbol for any comment that appears on a row, column, or cell with the tooltip that explains what the comment is. Additionally, you can come up to notes and turn on the footnote, which will show a bar at the bottom with all available comments added to this matrix. You can further configure the comments as well if you come up to settings, where you have the option to configure the symbol between numbered, lettered, arrow, or asterisk, with additional configuration options as well. You can also see in the status bar at the bottom, there are three pages right now available to tab between. I can choose to have pagination turned on or turned off by coming up to the advanced settings, going to pagination, and choosing responsive, fixed rows, or none. And if I select none, a scroll bar then appears, and I'm now able to scroll rather than tab between the pages. I can also easily apply a top end filter, which in this case allows me to apply a top 5 by value for the subcategory with showing the rest as others. And if I select apply, you'll see the top 5 categories still displayed under home appliances and any of the other categories, with an option for others at the bottom with a count of how many are grouped into the others. I can also add my own custom rows if I choose. I'm going to come into here and I'm going to add a new row for kitchen that will combine refrigerators, coffee machines, and microwaves. I'm going to select insert, add calculated row. I'm going to call this kitchen. Select create, and now it added a new custom row for me that combines the values of all three of those subcategories. And rather than using a template, I can also build out my own custom KPI scorecard with ease. To start with, let's go ahead and add a sparkline. As long as you have a date period on columns, you can select any of the values here, such as actuals, come up to sparkline, and we have a few different options to choose from. I'm going to choose the spline area, select that, and let's go ahead and reconfigure the scale to individual, resize this just a little bit, and then move this to the end. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to create a visual to compare my actuals with my forecast. So I'm going to come up to the bullet chart, and as you can see, we have three primary categories here. We have a series of bullet charts where two values are being compared, three values are being compared, or up to five values. For the two values, we have an option for IBCS bullet as one example. Another example is Stephen Few's qualitative bullet. We have those same two as well for three values for integrated variance overlap, and again the qualitative bullet with marker. And for the five value sections, we actually have stacked charts available to use as well. Let's go ahead and select the IBCS bullet, and I'm going to grab this and move this behind the trend line. Select this. Let's customize it a bit by coming up to here, turning on the target marker, and an additional KPI for target and variance percentage. And one of the beautiful things about the IBCS bullet is that it normalizes the data to the target level, so you can see all of the variables and how they compare either above or below the target that they're aiming towards. And to make sure this follows the IBCS patterns, notice that forecast actually has the hatched pattern. So we're also going to come up to the pattern up here for fill and take the target and change that to hatched to match the forecast as well. There we go. Select close. And now I'd like to select the plan variance. I'm going to come up to home. I'm going to add a waterfall chart and choose a colored one. And notice that the plan is using the outline pattern. So we're going to come up to customize, go to fill pattern, and choose outline as well to match that. And we have an option to resize these as well if we'd like. So I'm going to make this a little bit bigger to make it easier to see. It's going to also mention that universal scaling will be disabled, so we can select proceed. And lastly, I would like to show the prior year variance as a lollipop chart. I'm going to come up and select that. And again, I'm going to make this just a little bit bigger. And one of the great features of the lollipop chart is the ability to add outliers. So I will select enable outlier. I will set my negative threshold, -25, and my positive threshold to 80. Select apply. And now you can see where the values go above or below those thresholds, you will now get an arrow indicating that that threshold has been exceeded. Now let's finalize this by cleaning up a bit and removing the unnecessary columns. Since we already have the data visualized for all of these base values in the visualization themselves, we can turn them off here. And I'm already displaying all of my forecast variance values in the visual itself, so I can turn those two off as well. Close this down. And there you go, in a matter of a few clicks, we've almost instantly created a KPI scorecard dashboard with the ability to expand and collapse and do pivot analysis on this. And last but not least, just like in the professional edition, you have the ability to quickly format the values. Uniform, which applies a universal format at the auto, thousands, millions, billions, or trillions level. Measure level, which formats each measure individually. Auto, which formats each cell individually, or native. As an example, if we selected auto, we can see that each individual cell now gets its own individual formatting. Overall though, one of the most important features is the ability at the row level inside of a matrix visual to be able to add various types of charts and graphs, which previously has not been available with any native visuals in Power BI, and even today is not available in most of the other competing softwares, such as ClickView or Tableau, nearly to this detail and customizability. So the Inforiver alone adds huge value proposition for customers who want to consolidate their BI platforms into a single location within the Microsoft stack.